Welcome back to Proactive, and I'm joined on the line now by John Croft, who's the non-executive chairman at Aura Renewable Acquisitions, a main market listed SPAC. And firstly, a very warm welcome to you, John. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you, and thanks for inviting me on. Appreciate it.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Perhaps the best place for us to start today, John, is by me asking you, what is the big idea behind Aura, and what is it that you're trying to achieve?
Right, so, I mean, obviously, you know, the renewable sector is a hot sector. There's a lot of interest, a lot of excitement around the sector, and there are some great companies that are coming, you know, coming into the market. So we think it's a sector which is going to have a lot of interest for investors. And that's why we set the vehicle up to look to acquire business in the sector. And obviously with the hope that it gets a very good following as and when we find one.
All understood. Thank you very much, John. So it started, I believe, back in 2021. How do you feel like progress has been so far?
Yeah, well, obviously, 2022 was a bit of a difficult year for capital markets generally. And, you know, but during that time, we did quite a lot of looking around at opportunities. There weren't a lot of transactions going on, but we did use the time quite productively, I'd say. And we've been in touch with a number of companies across the globe looking at potential opportunities. So, yeah, 2022 was quiet, but we set the company up to be able to be patient and to find the right deal. We raised around £1 million plus at the original IPO. And we don't have many costs. We had some costs around the IPO itself, but apart from that, there are no fees being paid to directors or anything like that. So our cash is pretty well preserved, and we announced our results for last year recently, and we disclosed that we had over £800,000 of our original million still in the bank, and that will last us a very long time. So yeah, 2022 was a bit quiet in terms of doing an actual transaction, but we've been working quite hard in the background.
Indeed, John, that certainly tallies with what we've been hearing here on Proactive. And another thing that we've been hearing is that for those who are sitting on a bit of money, there are opportunities out there. So how confident are you that 2023 will be the year that you make a transaction?
We're very hopeful, put it like that, that we can do a transaction in this year. I mean, the sectors that we're particularly interested in are in the sort of energy storage generally, but particularly in battery technologies. I mean, if you think about the application of battery technologies, everybody talks about electric vehicles, but you know, that's just one small part of the whole market. So we've seen opportunities where battery technologies are beginning to be used in all sorts of applications, including in drones, boats, even aeroplanes. You know, we're beginning to see short-haul aeroplanes on test flights with battery technologies. So there's a huge opportunity there, and we're particularly interested in these sectors. So yeah, I'm very hopeful we'll do something this year.
And for those who have not been following too closely the world of SPACs, you're obviously deeply embedded in that community. So what's actually been going on? What are the trends at the moment?
I think in the UK, it's interesting. It's a very different market to the SPAC market in the US, where there have been massive SPACs put in place with up to billions of dollars being put in effectively into a cash shell and then looking for very large transactions. The market in London used to be, there used to be no downside limit, if you like, on the size of a transaction, which meant that you could do a transaction in the sort of £5 to £10 million range. And the valuation of the SPAC in that context becomes very important, because if you're looking at a valuation of £1 to £2 million for your SPAC, and the valuation of the overall business is only £5 to £10 million, then obviously it's a very significant part. But with the minimum capitalization having been moved up to £30 million, it means actually that the valuation of the SPAC in the context of an overall transaction is relatively small. So we're starting to see, excuse me, we're starting to see valuations for SPACs in transactions heading up. And recently there have been some in London where the SPAC has been valued at multiple times of its cash balance and multiple times the value of its original market cap at the time it came to the market. So we see that as being very encouraging and a positive sign for our shareholders going forward.
Well, John, let me wish you the very best of luck with it, and thank you very much for your time today. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate the time.